Chris Pritchard here, talking about the Distinguished Club program from a sporting angle. So I've got my baseball jersey on. So what is the Distinguished Club program? It is a set of goals that is used to measure the club. And that's fine, because you should measure something against a standard. The problem happens when you take the standard and make that the goal. A yardstick is not a goal. I'll repeat that. A yardstick is not a goal. A measurement is not the goal. And that's what's happened with the Distinguished Club program. It's switched. It's the cart before the horse. The measurement is now the goal, instead of the goal being the goal. So let's take a look at football. So I have a goal for this coming game. I want to get 400 yards of offense, and I want to get 25 first downs, and I want to score 4 touchdowns. What happens if I get 375 yards of offense, 5 first downs, and 35 points? I won the game. I had a great game, but I didn't meet some of these imaginary goals, these goals that didn't have anything to do with really the outcome of the game. Because I didn't have to. I intercepted a pass. I recovered a fumble. I scored on one play with no first downs. So what happens when the goal becomes more important than winning? And that's what's happened with the Distinguished Club program. The goal is more important than winning. If you have a good club, and the good club has 18 members constantly, maybe 17, 19, never makes 20, it's not distinguished. Could get all those educational awards, do everything, be everything a good club is, but didn't make 20, it's no good. Because they've lost track. They didn't meet the one goal that's supposed to be important. But what about a club with 20 members and 5 goals? It's distinguished. It's great. And I happen to know from actual experience that 1 or 2 members can get all the educational awards, even with the new system, can game the system to get to 5 points. We want members to do things, not for them, but for their club. What do you mean for the club? Well, they have to get DCP points or goals so the club can become a distinguished club. And then we can have a distinguished area and a distinguished division and finally a distinguished district. Okay, what about the member? The member's doing it for themselves, not for everybody else. So one day I got a call from the area director, a good guy. He said to me, "Hey, Chris, you know, you're very close to being a distinguished club." Yeah, I know that. I know I've been here long enough. I've heard this year after year after year. I know that we're close to being distinguished. Our club never has more than 18 members. "Well, if you get 2 more members and 1 more award, you will be select distinguished." And I said, "I'll check my pockets. Nope, I don't have 2 more members and 1 more award. And anyway, I'm not going to put in a member in the middle of June just to get an award to get a ribbon." So let's look at that problem. I don't want to cheat members. So a member comes in June and it's the last 2 weeks of June. I'm not going to put their membership in the last 2 weeks of June if they just showed up. I'll wait till July, because every other month I would wait to give them the benefit of the full month. So why would I cheat them in June just to get a ribbon? And I've seen a lot of people whose memberships are put in the last day. And that has always annoyed me, because we have something called the 4 core values, IRSE. And I wonder which one of the 4 core values tells you should put a member in and make him pay dues for 1 day and not get the benefit of it. So what's wrong with the Distinguished Club program? A lot. I could talk about this for an hour. I've done it all. I know how to game the system legally. I know how to not game the system. I've learned to play by the rules, but I don't use it as a goal. The Distinguished Club program should not be a goal. Remember, the yardstick is not the goal. The goal is to have good meetings, to have members get experienced, members speak, members enjoy, and the club is a great experience. That's what the goal of Toastmasters should be, not that everybody get a ribbon.